At this point, you know how to push changes to your remote on GitHub. Now let's discover how you can actually bring changes to your local repository on your computer. In this video, we'll cover a bit about GitHub's graphical interface and how to manipulate your code and make commits. From there, we'll discuss why you need to have the ability to bring commits from your remote to your local repository. Afterwards, we'll cover the Git commands that'll help you to request changes from your remote repository. Let's go ahead and get started. In our Hello World repository, I want to make a change to my README from GitHub. You'll notice that if I click on a document in my project folder on GitHub, I can open that document. Once open, you'll notice a pencil on the right-hand side that allows you to edit a document. If you click on it, your document is now in a text editor where you can make changes. When you scroll all the way down, you'll notice something else. Here we are presented with the option to commit changes. Like your local repository, any change made on GitHub requires a commit. Since we are making changes, I would still highly recommend using a branch anytime you add a new feature to your code to keep your master branch safe. Now, I understand we're only making some change to text, which may not require the use of a branch, but this will be good practice. Let's scroll back to the top and click our repo name, Hello World, to go back to the root of our repository. In order to make a new branch, you have to go to the area that says branch. You should notice at this point we only have one branch, which is our master branch. Let's create a new one by typing the name of the branch we would like. I'll call it Update Hello World. You'll notice that where our master branch was listed, that now we have a prompt to create a new branch from master being the base branch. I will click on it and there you have it. We now have a new branch. Since we're now in that branch, let's go ahead and go into our README and make our edits. I'm just going to change our Hello World into a header 1 using markdown by adding a pound sign or a hashtag. I'm going to scroll to the bottom and add a message to my commit. Message will be update README by adding header. Now notice you can also create a branch here if you wanted to make a new change, but I wanted to show you the other option as well. We're going to commit directly to our update Hello World branch. Commit changes and great. Now let's go back to our local repository. Notice that if I check the status of my repo that there are no changes in my working directory or my staging area. So all of the changes I made on GitHub do not automatically sync with my local repository. I need to request those changes. So the bigger question is, why did we make changes to our GitHub repository so that we can request those changes locally? Think about it this way. The beauty of GitHub is that you can collaborate with team members. Your students could collaborate with each other, or you could collaborate directly with them. With that, if one of you pushes changes to a repository from a local machine, the other person will need those changes if they want to update their code. So in this case, we've simulated changes that have been pushed by another user. Now we want to get those changes and bring them to our local machine. There are two ways to do this. First, we're going to go through the what I like to call the safe way of grabbing changes from your remote. The safe way is to use the git command fetch. Fetch will fetch the information on the remote branches, such as master and the other branch we created, but does not make any changes to your local master branch. So if I use git fetch, notice that we'll show that I have downloaded changes from GitHub. If I type in git branch, notice that I have my master branch only. Where did the information go? Right? I pulled it down from GitHub. I would think that my branch that I created on GitHub would also be here as well. Well, it's actually there from a remote reference. If I type in git checkout and the name of the branch from GitHub, so update Hello World, there it is. I'm now on the update Hello World branch. And if I git log, I'll see the commit I made on GitHub. You also have the option of fetching changes and merging them directly into your local machine using another git command, which is pull. Let's make another change on GitHub. This time I'm going to add Hola Mundo to our README on master. I'm going to commit these changes with the message update README with Spanish translation, and I'm going to commit. Now, pull will grab any changes done to master. So if you had some changes committed to master, pull will grab them from the remote and merge them directly into your local master. So on the command line,
type in git pull origin master.
Good, the pull was successful. Now if I check my git log, great, the new commit is there. You now have the ability to interact with your remote, and you are a step closer to being effective with Git and GitHub. We will continue to learn more ways you can collaborate using GitHub.